Good evening, yogis. Welcome to this beautiful online space where I will be holding a moment for you and your yoga practice. So my name is Kamila, and I'm inviting you tonight to a Yin yoga practice for self-love. We're approaching the Valentine's day, which is on Sunday, so we can start to connect to this beautiful energy of love. And when we think love, we are often good evening, good evening, good evening. People are gathering already, so I'm really, really happy. So when we think about love, we are thinking about sending love to others and sharing the love with people around us, with our friends, family, beloved ones. Yet, possibly one of the most important people you can offer the loving energy to is yourself. And especially now, more than ever, each of us needs this very much self-love foundation, especially that we cannot connect with other people the way we used to, and all those disruptions and lockdowns and feeling constricted creates obstacles and challenges in our life. So we can direct this energy inwards. And yoga is a beautiful path, beautiful way to help us to do so. So I'm inviting you tonight to practice with me, Yin Yoga, and really give yourself this moment and this time to settle into your own space, into the space within your heart, within your soul, within your body, and really shower yourself with the loving energy. Shower yourself with the most love you can possibly give to yourself to fill in all those spaces and places which might be hurting at the moment, which might be longing for someone, which might be missing people who are close to us. So really allowing ourselves to repair and shower ourselves with love. So this is my intention for the class tonight, and this is my intention for you. And definitely we're here together and we'll be practicing in this beautiful community so we can strengthen this energy and add to it and create this amazing resonance which will help all of us. So for this practice tonight, I'm inviting you to prepare your yoga mat, or you can practice on the floor. You can also use a blanket, or else you can use the scarf, for example, and fold it into a little sushi roll. So you can use it as a support underneath your back or underneath your chest. We will go into a lovely heart-opening asanas today, and working with the back bends as well, and really allowing our body to bathe in the energy of love. Lovely. So we'll start sitting today. The bolster is very welcome too. So if you have a bolster, you can use the bolster, or you can use folded towel or a blanket, whatever is most handy for you. So we'll start with the seated position. So you can sit in Sukhasana. Sukhasana is easy pose in yoga, and you can sit either cross-legged, or else you can have one foot in front of the other. You can rest your hands on your thighs. Lengthen your spine to create space in your back, in your spine. And just taking a couple of nice long breaths through your body, allowing the energy to travel easily, freely. So you can bring both hands onto your heart and just tuning to the rhythm of your heart. Perhaps you can feel the heartbeat in your palms. So just imagining that you're holding your beautiful heart in the palms of your hands. You're here to support yourself, to nurture yourself, to nourish yourself. And tune into your physical sensations in the body right now. So how is your body feeling tonight? How are your emotions? Are some emotions coming into the surface to look for your attention and acknowledgement? How are you feeling mentally? How are your thoughts? Just observe, no judgment. And just being lovingly present to yourself. And how are your energies in your body, in your being? And breathing in and out through the nose. So connecting to this transformative energy of love flowing through your body. Flowing into every cell of your body. Purifying, nurturing, nourishing, alchemizing. So really allow yourself to feel that. Allow yourself to experience the loving energy being present for you in this moment. Beautiful. So you can very gently open your eyes. First pose we're gonna go into is our butterfly. So you can bring your feet together in front of you and you can push them a little bit away from the center of your body. So here I'm sitting on the bolster. I'm doing a lot of walking these days and I feel the bolster is really nice and helpful for my sit bones and also for sciatica nerve in my legs. So if you want to use the support underneath your hips, please do, or else check it out and see how the body feels with support or without support. And here we'll start to bring the body forward. So bringing the body forward and seeing here, how are you feeling in your hips? How are your hip groins? So we will stay in this pose for 5 minutes. So nice, juicy 5 minutes to allow our hips, our back, our head, really to soften into this beautiful surrender. So surrendering to the moment, surrendering to yourself and allowing yourself to calm down the energies in the body. So in Yin Yoga, we hold the postures for a prolonged period of time so the body finds its natural way to realign and readjust. The purpose of it is also going deeper into the soft tissues in the body, deeper into the ligaments and into the bones as well. So sometimes often body stores emotions, and the emotions which might have been experienced a long time ago, they are stored deeper in the body. So Yin Yoga would be one of the ways to access those emotions and allow them to release patiently, lovingly, and gently. So if you can stay for a longer period of time in stillness, in the outer stillness, because inside your body there's a lot of energies moving at all times, yet outwardly you're just encapsulated in a shape, in a particular asana for those couple of minutes. Yet if the pain comes into the physical sensations, move out. And you have a choice to access the asana one more time, finding a different edge and softer space in your body to experience. Or else you can sit it out or go into a child's pose. So really allow yourself to drop deeply into your sensations. So the sensations in all the bodies of your being are your guidance. Always follow your natural, innate wisdom of your own body. Our bodies are the vehicles for change, transformation, experience. Breathing spontaneously, naturally, in and out through the nose. So one more minute. Breathing in and out. Really allowing yourself to experience achiness, a little bit of discomfort are welcome. Pain is not. Well, we can welcome pain, yet physically it's good to not go all the way into painful sensations, because that can create injury in the body. And it takes longer to heal, and it's better to work with the safe capacities of the bodily experience. So learning the art of dialogue with your own body. So now very gently starting to come out of the asana. And this is the moment when your body might feel a little bit achy, a little bit, oh, I feel like I'm 20 years older. That's normal. This is normal, and it's part of the Yin Yoga practice. But after the class, trust me, you'll feel so much better. And so moving your knees from side to side. So moving your hips. Exploring what is happening in the hips. So nice counter movement in the body. Breathing in and out. Beautiful. Lovely. And now we will go into our back bend for tonight, and the back bend will be an anahata asana, so our beautiful heart opening asana. So for this, I ask you to prepare a little scarf or a blanket, rolled up blanket. You can also use a block or a bolster for this. So you're gonna place it one third on your mat, and the purpose is it's gonna your heart will rest on the support. You can also not use the support if you like, so your heart can perhaps go all the way down onto the mat, but see which version would be good for you today. So this is also a place where we will stay for 3 minutes, so a little bit shorter. So here, your knees are open, hip width distance apart. I'm just gonna bring the hands to the front, and you will start to bring your heart onto the mat, so or else onto the support, onto your scarf or your block or your bolster. And here you have a choice to either place your forehead on the mat, or else you can place your chin on the mat. So see what is happening in your lower back, what is happening in your whole body. And you can also work with the height of the block or a folded scarf or a blanket underneath your heart. So this is a beautiful way to open the heart, to surrender the heart to the earth. And also working here with your solar plexus, the center of your power. So a place where your stomach, your liver resides. And really giving it all to the heart. So bowing all the way into your life experience. Lovingly allowing yourself just to be. So observing the sensations. Is it challenging? What is coming up on the physical level, on the emotional level? Perhaps there are some thoughts in your head. When will it be over? I'm joking. It will be, eventually. So breathing naturally, freely through your nose. Knowing that you can move out or change your position at any moment. Yet if you can stay with the sensations, it will be very, very beneficial for your body. So taking a nice long breath. And now very, very gently moving up, moving out from the asana, sitting on your heels. Bringing the hands on your thighs, lengthening your spine. closing your eyes and feeling the sensation. So where do you feel it in your body? How are the sensations experienced? And just allow yourself to recalibrate and soften, feeling the energies moving through the body. This is a very powerful backbend, very powerful pose of surrender. Beautiful. Lovely. Now we will go into pigeon pose on the left and the right side. We'll start on the right and we're going to do it with the bolster. So bring the bolster one third on the mat, and again you can have your rolled blanket or rolled towel prepared. And here we're going to bring the right leg in front of the bolster. Here, take a moment to align your body on the bolster and have a look over your left shoulder. If your ankle is aligned with the knee and the knee is aligned with the hip, and more importantly, how does it feel in your body? Are there any aches or pains? Aches are good. Pains need to be tended to and adjusted. So here we'll start with the high swan, so swimming swan on the lake. Did I say swan? I did say swan. Swan or pigeon. So you can imagine that you are either a pigeon or a swan. Beautiful, graceful. So swimming on the lake. So here we're accessing the glutes, accessing the hip, and sending a lot of loving energy into the hips, into our buttocks, and the hips especially. So the hips are the support of the body. So our hips are the center of really holding everything together, holding the base of our body and the crown of our body together. So this is a very important junction in terms of the human anatomy. So pouring love into the hips. The love which will lubricate the hips, lubricate the joints in our body, and really allow us to move more efficiently, with more grace, with more spring in our step. And again, feeling into the sensations. If there is any type of pain, please move out from the asana. Find a more comfortable place to go into it again, or as you can sit it out and just give yourself a moment of reflection. So let's see if you can lower yourself a little bit down so your head can rest on your forearms in front of you. So going into this nice sleeping pigeon, sleeping swan. That will intensify the sensations in your hip. This is normal. So seeing if you can soften, if there are some parts of your body which you can soften. So we are working here with the particular area of the body.
Yet each body is so complex and different, so you might feel it in different areas as well. So breathing in and out through the nose, really allowing the energy to flow through your body. Taking one last breath in here. Beautiful.
And now coming back up, all the way up, and lengthening the leg in front of you. So going into a little mini split. So this is a nice way of working towards a split in the body. So really seeing what is happening at the back of the legs, especially the front leg. And here. Beautiful. And now bring the leg all the way back. And sit on your heels. Lengthen the hands in front on your thighs, lengthen your spine, breathe. Beautiful. And now we will tend to the left side of our body. So the left leg will go in front of the bolster. And here, feel how does it feel in your body. If your bolster is high enough as well, you can use some extra support, which is the blanket, just to the blanket or a towel. So you need to see how it feels in the body. The sensations in your body are the best indication here. And here, look back towards your right leg and see if the ankle is aligned with your knee and the knee is aligned with your hip. And you can stay nice and tall in here on your arms. Looking forward. Tending into your hips, into your glutes. Sending loving energy all the way into the hips and the buttocks. For carrying you through all the challenges, all the rough patches in life. We're still here, still standing, or flowing on the lakes, oceans, rivers of life, like swans, like birds. Breathing into the sensations. What are you feeling in your body right now? Little achiness and discomfort are welcome. Pain is an indication to move out from the asana, from this shape. And bringing the breath into the sensations you're feeling and experiencing in your body. And just knowing that this particular practice is designed to access the deeper layers in your body. So you can be freer in movement. And so lower yourself down if you like to intensify the sensations. So you can rest your head on your forearms. Breathing in and out through the nose.
Sending love to your hips, sending love to your whole body. And allowing the love to dissolve any blockages, any places which might be a little bit tensed or stressed. Breathing in and out through the nose. And taking a last deep breath in here. Beautiful.
And now gently bringing yourself back up and lengthening the left leg all the way forward. Really allowing the back of your leg to straighten. Lovely. And bringing your leg all the way back. Bringing the hands down. Down on your thighs, breathing in and out through the nose. Lovely. And now we will go into one more back bend. This time we will do it with the help of the block. So you can use a book. You can also use your scarf, but fold it really, really tight so it has a really nice height in it. And here you can experiment. So you can bring the block or a scarf as well, like whatever the height will be. So you can bring it on the first height, which is the smallest height, or the second height, which is the medium height, and then it has the third height, which is the highest height. So you can bring it either onto the smallest, or else we can start with the smallest and see where it's gonna bring us. So you will bring it under your under your thoracic spine, which is your middle spine, and underneath the space between your shoulder blades. So see if you can lie down over your block, so your thoracic spine, so your middle spine will lift, but just make sure so it feels like really, really free in the body. So you can also do it on the bolster, but the bolster might be very high or very low depending of the height in there. So the book or the block are a little bit firmer here. And seeing if you can move your head from side to side and if the neck is free. So here your heart is lifted, your chest is open, your lungs. Just connecting to opening the heart, alleviating the energy from the heart, and opening for receiving the loving energy towards ourselves, towards our body, towards our mind, emotions, thoughts. Towards every part of ourselves. Breathing in and out through the nose. So we won't stay here for as long as this is our second deep back bend. So observing your breath and the quality of your breath, are you able to breathe freely, or is the breath contracted in any part of your body? If so, just observe it. You don't have to change it in any way. It will change when it's ready. But just observing it. Lovely, and taking a last breath in here. And now bend your knees, elevate your sit bones and your pelvis, remove your block, or bring it to the side, and bring your back flat on the floor. And you can bring your knees towards your chest. Beautiful. Hugging them nice and tight. Excellent. Now we will do a little sacrum reset, and we're going to use the block underneath the sacral part of the back, which is the lowest part of the back. And the sacrum is the flat bone, quite a big bone on your lower back. So just make sure the block feels comfortable. You can also use the book as well. And here we're going to bring the legs up. And you can flex your feet or stretch to your toes, or just change from one to the other. So we will stay here for a minute. Just allowing the breath to travel through your body. So really nice inversion and something to move the blood flow, move the energy, and also improve the condition of the heart. Excellent. And now bend your knees, bring your feet down, lift your pelvis, and bring the block down to your side. And so move your knees to your right side, both knees, so a gentle twist to the right side. And here you can bring your head to the left, open your arms down your sides, and just feeling into the nice twist in the spine. Excellent. Sending love into your spine, into the twist, into all the places in your body which needs it right now. Coming back to the center with your knees, with your head, placing the back on the floor, on the earth, feeling the support of the earth. And so moving your pelvis to the right, bringing your knees to your left and your head to your right side, breathing in and out through the nose. And so coming back to the center, bringing the knees towards your chest one more time. Bring the head towards your knees and squeeze your face, squeeze your legs, squeeze your whole body and release. Lengthen all the way down onto the mat into your final relaxation pose, into your shavasana. Allowing your whole body to recuperate. Rebalance. Absorb all the benefits. Allow it to manifest it. To manifest all those changes in your physical being. Now connect into your heart center, into your physical heart, but also the energetic heart in your body. So the center of love, compassion, self-love, kindness. So just imagine that there is a lotus flower growing and blossoming from the center of your heart chakra. So the lotus flower grows out of the mud, so out of the challenges, out of all the difficult experiences we're going through in life. So just connect to the energy of this beautiful purple, pink, red lotus flower growing from the center of your heart. Growing bright, vibrant, strong, soft and gentle. all in the same time. So connect to this loving energy within yourself. The loving energy which can help to transmute all the mood into this beautiful blossoming flower. Alchemize all the challenges and difficulties. So bringing it all together now. From the physical practice, from the meditation, from the shavasana, into your body. Allowing it to manifest in your physical self. Connect to your body once again. Connect to your fingertips, your toes. Moving them gently. Giving yourself a nice stretch. Very gentle, mindful. And finding a way to turn to your right side, allowing the blood to flow, awakening the body, giving yourself the most beautiful, loving embrace you can. And coming back to sit cross-legged on your mat. And bringing the palms of your hands together at your heart. Still connected to the lotus flower growing out of your heart. And bowing to yourself first for showing up as you are in love. And for practicing together, raising the vibration and connecting to the loving energy in today's yoga practice. Namaste. Oh, thank you so much, yogis. Beautiful practice. May it serve you well.